I hear that train is coming, it's rolling round the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom prison, and time keeps dragging on, but that train keeps on rolling on down to San Antonio. I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But that train keeps on moving, and that's what tortures me. Well, if they freed me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Far from this Folsom prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
I want to know everything about you.
Spend all of your day with me.
I want to know even things that you don't know about yourself.
Every day, all day, for at least one whole year.
Let's make a pact that we don't spend any time with anyone else.
Blood pact.
Yes.
No other ladies or maids or...
Never.
Or we don't dilute this with other friends.
Other friends take you away from me.
Ask if I can move up to your room in the big house.
I'll move to Holbeck and I'll sleep in your bedsit and I'll wear one sad woolen outfit and eat things that are exclusively brown.
Or that.
Maybe I'll contract a disease. It'll be amazing.
Let's spend the rest of our lives together.
Yes, forever. Both wear pink.
Brothers for husbands.
Children who marry each other.
I want to stay within 5 paces of you at all times.
Yes.
At all times.
Yes.
No, at all times.
I want to literally open you up and scoop out your insides and climb inside your skin so we can become one person.
Yes, okay, no, yes, okay.
Sorry, was that too much? It just feels like we're actually already one person thinking
the same thoughts constantly all the time.
Wow. Yeah. Maybe we were twins. Non-identical twins, separated at birth and taken to different parts of
dropped in a basket in the river or a chopped
and
door.
And I ended up massively rich.
Yeah.
And you ended up...
Yeah, poor, yeah.
Okay, on the three, say your birthday. 1, 2, 3.
February 12th.
But still, I'm going to eat you.
I'm going to eat you.
Not if I eat you first.
I feel like we are literally exactly the same.
I feel like I've had you forever. Like my foot or my spleen or...
I feel completely the same.
What's your name?
You've got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart.
I have often asked myself the reason for the sadness in a world where tears are just a lullaby. If there's any answer, maybe love can end the madness. Maybe not, oh, but we can only try. You've got to get up every morning with a smile on your face and show the world all the love in your heart. Oh, and people gonna treat you better.
Seen me.
He hasn't seen you. It's fine. He's not even looking over here. He's at the bar. He's over there.
Are you sure he hasn't seen me?
He's at the bar. He's getting 2 drinks. He hasn't seen you.
Okay.
So, who is he?
He's Tom.
Yeah, Tom, you said, but Which Tom?
You know which Tom. You know, I mean, how many Toms are there? Oi, don't make me feel like a slag.
But you are a slag.
There's only one Tom. I treated him like shit, that Tom.
Oh.
Yeah.
He's coming back.
Shit, can he see us?
Oh, no, wait a sec, he's going to a table. He's sitting down. He's facing two girls.
Yeah, he's fine. He hasn't seen us.
He must have seen us. How can he go right up to the bar and back again and not see us?
Because he wasn't looking over here.
What the fuck does he think he's playing at? If he comes past her again, I'm gonna say something to him.
I thought you didn't want to see him.
Yeah, but he's ignoring me. He's ignoring me. Fuck that. Yeah, well, he has a really thick cock anyways. Like really thick. Like I'd never had one like it before.
Thick? Rather than long?
Yeah, really thick. Like not particularly long, but not uniformly thick. Like a traffic cone.
Thicker at the bottom than at the tip, you mean?
A cornetto cock!
Oh, I don't like them.
Yeah. It did look scary, I remember.
How thick?
God, like about... No, wait, hang on, the base was kind of like, more like, no, wait, oh.
Not so long then.
No. You know, Lisa still hasn't spoken to me ever since she found out about me and him.
She found out? How did she find out?
Well, she asked me straight out whether anything happened between me and him.
Shit.
So, I told her the truth.
Why?
Well, she asked me straight out. I couldn't lie, could I?
So, what did you say?
I told her that we'd snogged each other.
You'd snogged each other. You told her that you and
Tom... Yeah, I had to tell her the truth.
But you didn't.
Didn't what?
Tell her the truth. You fucked him, Bella. You fucked him many times. You didn't just snog him.
Right. Yeah, well, I couldn't tell her that, could I? Obviously. Anyways, it doesn't matter. They've broken up anyway.
My love affair with you is over, it's through. We loved and then we lost, and while it came at quite a cost, we both had the chance to grow. I've collected my thoughts, and once before I go, there's just one thing I want you to know. I want to punch you in the face, rip out all your hair. I want to burn you alive, and if you survive, I'll strap you to an electric chair or lean out a window a little too far. Don't look both ways and get hit by a car. Fall out of a roller coaster. Take a warm bath with a blackened toaster. In short, I hope you fucking die.
Don't you notice how I get quiet when there's no one else around? Me and you and awkward silence. Don't you dare look at me that way. I don't need reminders of how you don't feel the same. Oh, the burning pain, listening to you hop on about some. One day, run to me, confess your love. shoots an arrow through my heart. And I sound like a loon, but don't you feel it to confess I loved you from the start.
So where's my sister then?
Oh, with Mike somewhere, some dark corner.
Oh, she's mad about him.
Do you want to dance, Teddy?
Yeah, all right.
Oh, no, not like that.
How then?
Just put your arms around me and... That's it.
Now what?
Come a bit closer.
Like that?
Yeah, that's good. I've never seen you this close up before.
What you reckon?
You look like Grace.
Except I got the good looks.
Your eyes are green though.
Yours are brown.
You're shaking.
Am I?
Oh, I just want this year to be over, don't you?
Not right now.
I want to pretend it didn't happen. I want to scrub it out.
You can't do that.
You can make yourself forget though. I'm getting good at that.
You're beautiful, you are.
Oh no, don't start with all that. That's not what I want.
It was really nice having you around the house all the time. When we were kids. I used to sit outside Grace's bedroom and listen to the two of you. When you were in there, it was like everything was brighter or something. Better. And I used to...
Oh, it's really stupid. But I used to think that we'd get married. I thought about what dress you'd wear. Have you got your car?
Thought about hiring a camper van and the two of us just leaving in the middle of the night. We could go up to the lakes. Stupid, isn't it? But it's what I thought.
Come on.
Let's keep dancing a bit longer.
Don't you want me, Teddy?
Can't we just talk for a while?
I don't want to talk.
What are you getting at?
Are you really this stupid, Ted?
Hang on, what?
Have you ever been anywhere?
Yeah. Yeah, I've been places.
Where?
All right, let's see. Newcastle, Manchester. My granddad lives in Sheffield.
Oh, the kiddie heights.
Are you having a go at me?
Let's go somewhere. Let's go somewhere dark and quiet. Come on.
My dearest, radiant beauty and fine young lady, I've spoken with your father, and he says we're good to go, as it were. So, would you do me the honor, nay, the privilege of finally becoming my wife?
No.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. To say that.
That's
I'm not sure what came over me.
Okay.
A turn or the heat, probably.
Right, yeah.
Could we try that again? I think I just need to get in the mood.
Okay.
Will you marry me?
No.
Oh, really? I don't mean to say it. It just keeps coming out. Just keep. Will you marry me?
No.
Could.
Nope.
Perhaps.
Nuh-uh.
Would you consider?
No!
Will you?
Nope, nope.
Marry me?
Abso-fucking-lutely not.
Should I just,
Do you think you could hate me a little bit first?
Pardon?
It's just that I'd quite like for you to be completely repulsed by me initially. Do you think we could start again and try that?
The proposal or?
Yeah, the whole thing. Yes, if you could find me entirely disagreeable, that would be great.
Right.
If you could be physically angered by the sight of me. And I'm working something out here. I don't know, perhaps then very slowly through a series of chance encounters. We are forced to make terse conversation while my sister dances with your friend or...
Your sister?
Ooh. Perhaps I could tutor your young ward, who's actually the same age as me,
and you realise that I am clever, which is very confusing to you.
I don't have a ward.
But hot.
Crikey.
Right.
Or there's a blizzard.
A blizzard.
And we become stranded in a hostile climate, forced to take shelter in an abandoned hut by a frozen lake, with only our bodies for warmth, and there's just one single bed. And you offer to sleep on the cold floorboards like a Dalmatian, because what? You are a gentleman. And I tell you not to be so repressed and just get in the fucking bed with me, and I take you.
Oh.
Just take you right there. Just consume each other, just this grasping, crawling. I want the force of how much you want me to completely wipe out how much you hate me, for you to wake up in the night screaming in awe at my existence. I want it to feel biblical to you. I want to clasp your face between my hands and lick it all over, just lick you, and for you to want it. I am going to eat you alive, and you're going to say thank you. Nothing gentle. I want you grasping for me in the darkness.
Right.
I want you to propose to me like it's the worst day of your life, and I want you sobbing with fucking gratitude when I say yes!
Yes?
Well, then I might feel like I had a little say in the matter.
Listen. Hey. Shut up. I am not the kind of girl who responds to threats or pleas or cakes or sandwiches or whatever else you have to throw at me. In the buffet of life, I'm not a sandwich. I am sushi. Diamond sushi. And no, you can't take sushi out for a day in the sun and then leave it locked in a hot car with no windows rolled down. Because I tell you this, and I mean it. That sushi that you loved, that sushi will poison you. It'll poison you dead.
Little girls everywhere I turn, I can see them. Little girls, night and day, I eat, sleep and breathe them. I'm an ordinary woman with feelings. I'd like a man to nibble on my ear, but I'll admit, no man has bit. So how come I'm the mother of the year? Little cheeks, little teeth, everything around me is little. If I wring little necks, surely I would get an
So, I see you lurking in the box room, obviously trying to catch me for a quiet word. Typical. Well, I'm busy.
I honestly didn't know you were here.
That was some fun we had last night, wasn't it?
Well, it was a different sort of...
Of?
Game?
Game.
Look, Val, I think I might pop off.
Oh, please. Do you think I'm simple? You don't want to pop off. You think that you can swan into this soiree, bend down on your bent knee and offer me the moon? Well, you have another thing coming to you, Sallow. Who do you think you are? Some kind of superstar?
What?
What do you think?
I think we should not communicate. Ever. Never.
What?
I would just like it if we were not in contact.
And I won't respond to threats or pleas or cakes or sandwiches. I want sushi.
I'm sorry?
Diamond sushi. That's what I am.
Look, Val, I think I might leave you to it.
You lied to me. You lied to me. You lied to me so many times. You said you were finished with May. Lie. You said you had a dust allergy. False. Lie. I never even saw an inhaler. You said you wanted to go get Pop. Lie. You said you love me. Lie. Why? Why do you lie all the time?
I'm sorry.
No! No, sorry. Why? It can't be me. I'm really lovely. It must be you. So why?
I don't know.
Does it make you feel good?
Yes.
Well, it makes everyone else feel like dirt.
I don't even know what to say.
Don't say anything. Don't say anything. It'll do no good. You can't win me back.
Well, I don't actually want
to... You will never win me over again. I don't care how much you love me.
Oh, how awful. What a punishment.
Well, I could just tell May everything. It'd be the perfect reason to eject you from our house.
Please don't look. It's hard enough losing you.
Maybe I don't need to tell May. Maybe I can just show her the picture of your genitals that I have on my phone.
Look, please don't look. I'm talking to her tomorrow. We'll be finished. I promise.
Tomorrow? She's here now. I'll get her. May!
I'm 11, and I'm at my nan's. We're playing the card game, Uno. It's my nan, my mum, my brother, my uncle, and me. And my uncle and I are playing to lose. So, I'm sat at the table. My grandma stands up. She says, you know, Carl died. Carl was this 50-year-old guy who lived in the village. He smelled really good, though, like citrus. He also had a really fit daughter, Beth. Beth also smelled like citrus. So my grandma says, Carl died. And my mum just says, AIDS. She lays a green six. I didn't know what AIDS was, but the sound of the word felt insidious. AIDS. My mum explained, well, you know, it's tragic, but it probably was AIDS because he's gay and there's nothing wrong with that, but it's likely it was AIDS. She speaks as if she was reading the fucking weather report. It'll be stormy in Southend and breezy in Basildon, and Carl probably died of AIDS because he was gay. I laugh. I don't know why. It's awkward. You don't want to understand. My brother shouts. My mum screams, does it matter or not if he died of AIDS? The room is funeral quiet. My grandma stands up. It was a heart attack. Uno.
Folks, begging your pardon. Excuse me, sorry to barge in. Let's skip the tears and start on the whole, you know, being dead thing. You're doomed, enjoy the singing. The sword of Damocles is swinging. And if I hear your cell phone ringing, I'll kill you myself. The whole being dead thing. You're gonna be fine on the other side. That body in the pit. Gosh, it's awful, any tragic pop out Bible, Jesus, magic. When you're dead, who gives a shit? You need a leader who's smart to help you master the art of the whole being dead thing.
When you're gone, I feel alone again. The voices cannot hold my hand. They keep me company at very best. Distract me from my loneliness. Maybe I'm just an anomaly. Even my demons have families. Truly something must be wrong with me to need you as much as I do. Occupy for you, cause I love you so. Left me hanging at the station, but you'll be back for me soon. I'm out of desire, the only thing I find I'm worried about is you. Something tells me you aren't coming, guess I'm truly doomed. I'm out of desire, the only thing I find I'm worried about is you. I'm out of desire, the thing on my mind seems to be nearly nothing but you.
And I love it when you read to me. The book of love is long and boring. No one can lift the damn thing. It's full of charts and facts and figures and instructions for dancing. The book of love is long and boring and written very long ago. It's full of flowers and heart-shaped boxes, and things we're all too young to know. And
where'd you meet White Boots?
My date?
Mm-hmm.
My date's name is Joe.
Nice. And just to check, those are actually White Boots to a wedding.
I like them. Sure.
Just don't look directly at them. What are they made out of? The moon?
All right. Do you want to dance?
Me?
No. Why not?
People might see.
Who cares?
I look like a dick.
Oh, no, I really want to dance.
I don't have a rhythm.
Oh, make it up, come on. That'd be boring.
Fine, okay.
Oh, see? When was the last time we even ever did?
Years ago, on the allotments.
No, sorry. I meant see each other, not
Sorry. I thought you meant, fuck?
Christ. It's okay. No.
I wonder how long they've been dancing like that.
30 years.
You don't find that at a rave?
Or on Tinder.
Or anywhere. Really.
Not often.
I think those canapes might be a bit dodgy. Sorry. You go.
I said you should buy Joe a train ticket home.
Huh?
You asked me out that time at Pride.
I know, that was shit, I should have.
It's okay, I'm just saying, we're here now, so let's do it.
But Joe.
Oh, Joe doesn't care, Joe is a liberal.
Liberals have feelings too. The last time I checked, they have quite a lot of them.
Joe wore white boots to a stranger's wedding. Joe is laid back. Yeah, it's just forget about it. It was an idea, so, yeah.
We do keep meeting.
We do?
Like, fate? Mm.
No such thing, but sure.
You don't believe in fate?
Free will all the way. If I didn't believe in that, I'd kill myself.
But surely you believe in...
Well, love is just sex, and sex is just chance, and chance is just free will and timing. Come on, beat swiping right.
Less chance of repetitive strain injury.
Well, I can't promise that.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Good.
What the fuck do we tell Joe?
Devoted sisters, never had to have a chaperone, no sir. I'm here to keep my eye on her. All kinds of weather we seek together, the same in the rain or sun. Two different faces, but in tight places, we think and we act as one. Aha! Those who've seen us know that not a thing could come between us. Many men have tried to split us up, but no one can. Lord help the mister who comes between me and my sister, and Lord help the sister who comes between me and my...
One, two, three, four.
Sisters, sisters, there were never such devoted sisters. Many men have tried to split us up, but no one can.
I wonder why.
Lord help the mister who comes between me and my sister. And Lord help the sister who comes between me and my man. As if.
Yeah, right.
You went to see her?
No.
You told her where I am?
I didn't tell her anything.
I don't have time for this.
Would you have been mates with me?
What?
I feel stupid. You make me feel so... I just want to be your friend.
You're brilliant. I think you're brilliant.
So don't go. I don't think you should go. I don't want you to go.
Ellis, I have to.
I'll be on my own again.
And whose fault is that? Sorry.
No, go on.
I didn't mean... I just... If you stop trying to be different all the time, you know, stop acting like...
So I should keep my head down then, yeah? Be scared of everyone. Is it working for you?
I know what I'm doing.
You really believe that?
I can't stay here!
So we'll go somewhere else. You and me, yeah?
No, Ellis!
You think you're the only one who feels...
You don't know how I feel!
Look at me! I'm right here. Look at me. What am I meant to do?
I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen, so think for yourself for once instead of quoting things, talking shit, pretending to be something you're not.
You'll get yourself killed. You think I don't know anything. Every time my dad goes up there, he might not come back.
He doesn't, though. Does he? He doesn't go up there. Your dad doesn't fly a fucking typhoon. You know he doesn't. Mum says your dad's a drone pilot.
What?
My mum says your dad is a drone pilot.
He's not. How would she know?
Parents' evening. He's a drone pilot. You lied about it like you lie about everything.
I didn't.
Or you didn't lie, and you're just an idiot.
Fuck off.
He sits in a big metal box playing video games.
Shut up.
He kills people without putting himself in danger. Proper heroic, that.
Shut up.
He is a coward.
What am I then?
You're a...
Yeah. You want to say it, say it.
I don't.
Just like the rest of them.
Ellis, please.
So go then. Leave. Fuck off.
she moves like water. It is torture. All I want to do is drown. Get to know me. Keep me floating. Kill me slowly. I could never swim. But with you I dove right in. I didn't realize to love you was a sin. But I will rot in hell if you will as well. We don't have to tell. We can keep it down. I will burn alive if I can live my life the way I want tonight. I want to explore the extent of your ocean. Can I taste the salt of your unhinged emotion? Trying to swim, but I can't reach the surface. All of my friends think I'm drowning on purpose. But I will rot in hell, if you will as well. We don't have to tell, we can keep it down. I will burn alive, if I can live my life.
I fucked him.
Lucy.
I fucked Gary last week. Do you know what he did? After we finally did it, 9 years of angst and knowing we needed to be together in this weird, unspoken fuck up of a fucking situation. Him being scared of me and me being scared of myself. Do you know what he did? We lay there on the beach, 3 in the morning, completely naked, completely freezing. My nipples were hard. My breasts looked really good, really, really good. And do you know what he said? Shame you've got to get rid of these.
Oh my God, Lucy.
How did he know?
I didn't realize it was a secret.
It's a pretty weird thing to go around and tell everyone.
I didn't tell everyone. I thought you would have told him. He's known for a long time.
Since?
Your birthday? Your 22nd, I think. I was drunk.
Were you mad at me? Was it malicious?
No.
How did it even come up?
He was telling me how much he loved you. You were with her, you were talking to her, we were watching you both, and he didn't know what to do, and I just blurted it out. No, don't leave like this, Lucy.
Was he going to leave her?
I don't know.
Was he going to leave her for me?
Would you want to be with a man who couldn't love you with this?
It's the C word he's scared of, Jess. It's the fucking guarantee of that. It's the heartache of that. The broken mess of a wife. A skeleton of a wife. A wife whose every ounce of woman is threatened. Who would want to marry someone who might be stripped of their womanhood? I certainly wouldn't want to fucking marry someone like that.
You're not someone like that. You're Lucy. You're my Lucy. You're my wonderful Lucy.
He loves her. Thanks to you.
Oh, stop. Lucy, stop.
I fucking hate you. I hate everything that you are. I hate your mum. I hate the way you speak to your mum. I hate my dad for not being my mum. I hate your body. I hate your health. I hate your luck. I hate my fucking insides. I hate you. I hate you, and I never want to see your fucking face ever again.
watching me?
No.
You were, weren't you?
I wasn't, Jess.
Open my eyes, bang, you're there.
I was looking at you, that's different from watching.
It's a very disconcerting sight to wake up to. I was having a weird enough dream, as it was, and the last thing I need is to open my eyes and see you staring down at me.
You looked as though you were dreaming.
What on earth is that meant to mean?
You were moving around a bit, murmuring.
Oh my God, see? How long were you actually watching me for?
I wasn't watching you.
Were you having a...
No. I was awake for a bit. I couldn't sleep. You were rolling around, stealing the sheets. I mean, I went to go get a cup of tea. I couldn't find the kettle. I come back and you were still rolling all over the place. I couldn't not notice you. That would have just been weird, being in the same room and in the same bed as you and everything.
I don't steal the sheets.
You do, you know.
Nobody has ever accused me of stealing the sheets before.
Well...
What's your name?
Can't you remember?
Why would I ask if I could remember?
Michael. My name's Michael, Jess.
Nice to meet you, Michael. I'm Jessica.
Yeah, you said last night. What were you dreaming about?
I dreamt that somebody turned me into a bird.
Flippin' egg.
It was profoundly disconcerting.
A bird?
Yeah.
Could you fly?
I can't remember flying. I mainly remember them holding my hands back and turning them into wings. I didn't enjoy it, in case you were wondering. Did we have sex last night?
Blimey, Jess.
Did we have sex last night, I asked.
How drunk were you?
How drunk did I look? Did we?
No.
Are you sure?
I mean, yes, I'm completely sure.
Then what are you actually doing here?
I brought you home. You asked me to bring you home. I was gonna get an Uber.
Never trust an Uber.
Well, you begged me not to.
They're very lax on their security checkups and they don't pay taxes.
Yeah, you got quite upset about it.
I have very strong feelings on the matter.
Well, you said you didn't want to be on your own. You're a bit sick.
Shit.
I mean, it's all right. I got you to a toilet, I held your hair back for you, and I put you to bed. I was gonna go anyway, once you were asleep.
You fucking sneaky bastard.
I decided not to.
You were thinking about it, though.
I tried to sleep on the sofa, but that was a bit chilly, so I came back in here and tried the floor, but that fucked my back, so... So I just got in next to you. What?
A likely story. I don't have a kettle.
I noticed that.
They took all the trees and they put them in a tree museum. And now they charge all the people $1.50 just to see them. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone? They paved paradise and they put up a parking lot. Hey, farmer, farmer, put away that PPP now. Give me spots on my apples, but leave me the birds and the bees. Don't it always seem to go? Till it's gone. They paved paradise and they put up a parking lot. They paved paradise and put up a parking lot with a pink hotel, a boutique and a swinging hotspot. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone. They paved paradise and they put up a parking lot. Paradise and put up a parking lot.
It's been grand knowing you, grand knowing you, grand being your friend. You've been kind, loyal, and so generous, right down to the end. Please don't grieve watching me leave. That would be much too painful to stand. It's been fun, now I must run. But it's been grand, perfectly grand. Britannia, farewell. Sheddy, be brave. Chin up, it's been sublime. Just remember when you're lonely with dread, I'll be sleeping in my king's size Egyptian threat. So I hate leaving you, hate leaving your warm intimate club. It's been grand, let me say au revoir, goodbye. For it's grand knowing you'll all be working for your friend. Goodbye!
Unusual. They say strange fascination, infatuation, a lunatic. They say, what suits your taste? I just want a taste. And I always thought it's what inside that counts. Cause my insides are red and yours are too. And the red on my face is matching you. And goodness, you're bleeding. What a wonderful feeling. You're down and you're bleeding. And my head is reeling. The red means I love.
My days are so busy, it's making me dizzy. There's so much I gotta do. There's lunches and meetings and poetry readings and endless interviews. Then it's back to my room where I resume my attempt to write a hit. Just me and my beer and the terrible fear that I might be losing it. And it's hard, it's hard, it's really, really hard. So very, very hard. I make it look easy, but honey, believe me, it's hard. It's hard. It's so incredibly hard, so inconceivably, unbelievably hard. It's hard to be the bard, baby. I know writing made me famous, but being famous is more fun. And you're trying to find an opening line or a brilliant idea, and you're pacing the floor and hoping for, just a bit of divine intervention. That one little nugget, that one little spot, the eureka, you've got it, you're ready to start. So now you can write. Wrong, you're not even close. You remember that down at your place gonna be for that girl from EastEnders. And it's hard, it's hard, it's really, really hard. It's sexy, but it's hard. It's hard to be the bard.
I'm like a snowman, but hot. A lot of heat, but the cold don't stop. You kind of feel like you're trapped under a dome, which you call your home. What did you expect from this snow globe? No skiing, no exit. Stay put, you just gotta accept it. Watch you fall from night to day. The ceiling, dreaming of a better feeling. Cause I'm stuck in a huge snow globe. And I'm thinking this is it. And then I see the positive, all the glitter shining by my side. Just like my snow globe. Get out my snow globe. Somebody.
Disappointed.
You're tired. You're feeling the strain. There's no point denying it. Some people in the press, they're starting to think we're not up to this job. Scotland Yard. Yeah. They've been on the phone, offering us backup. And do you know what I told them? I said, thanks, lads. But you haven't solved your own bloody ripper case yet. So, don't lose faith. He's running scared. Since this room came together, he's not killed again. He's tried, and he's failed. So we're going to be one step ahead this time. We're going into his hunting ground.
These are my friends. See how they glisten. See this one shine. How he smiles in the light. My friend, my faithful friend. Speak to me, friend. Whisper, I'll listen. I know you've been locked out of sight all these years. Like me, my friend. Well, I've come home to find you waiting. Home, and we're together, and we'll do wonders.
Are still dancing in every room and every hall. Bet you thought I'd never do it, thought it'd go over my head. I bet you figured I'd pass with the winter, be something easy to forget. But I'm in the trees, I'm in the breeze, my footsteps on the ground. You'll see my face in every place, but you can't catch me now. You can't catch me now. I'm coming like a storm into your town. You can't catch me now. I'm higher than the hopes that you brought down. You can't catch me now. I'm coming like a storm into your town. You can't catch me now. I'm higher than the hopes that you brought down.
Do you reckon the stars can speak?
No.
Would be all right though, that.
Depends on what they would be saying.
Yeah, might be boring. Might just be like, you're right, mate. Yeah, yeah, not bad, not bad, not doing much. Just flirting and that. Yeah, me too, mate, me too. All right, see you later. Yeah, I mean, you'll definitely see me later because you were literally flirting right next to me and can't move.
I like the one that's just named Barry.
Yeah, he's all right.
Well, what's the other one called?
Dunno. Dave?
Dave and Barry. Couple of stars just floating next to each other, making awkward small talk like dads at barbecues.
Yeah. Do you remember that wish I told you about?
Yeah. The one for your dad?
Yeah.
Never came true, did it?
No.
Probably because I told you.
Probably because your dad's a penis?
Yeah, probably that. I don't know what you wrote in that letter to my mum. Don't think I ever want to.
Why not?
Because it's not for me.
So?
It's for my mum. It's for her to think about and sort out and stuff. I just try and help too much, and I don't think that's the right thing to do. Look at all those stars. You get like a million wishes.
Well, I think you only get one go.
No, you get more than that. I'd know that for sure. All those stars. You pick the right one at some point.
I guess.
I'll go for
that one. Which one?
That one. Looks all right. Looks wise.
Yeah.
Yeah, you reckon?
Yeah, I think so. I'll go for that one.
Which one?
The one that's blinking a bit.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like it wants some attention.
Yeah.
It looks like it's had a wish for ages, but no one's picked it.
I've just made about 50 more wishes on loads of stars. I think if one of them comes a little bit true, I'll be all right. But I won't tell you any of them this time. I won't tell you at all.
I was 21 years when I wrote this song. I'm 22 now, but I won't be for long. People ask me, when will you grow up to be a man? But all the girls I loved in school, they are already pushing prams. Oh, I loved you then as I love you still. Though I put you on a pedestal, they put you on a pill. I don't feel bad about letting you go. I just feel sad about letting you know. I don't want to change the world, no, I'm not looking for a New England. I'm just looking for another girl. I saw two shooting stars last night, I wished on them, but they were only satellites. It's wrong to wish on space hardware. I wish you cared. I don't want to change the world, no, I'm not looking for a New England. I'm just looking for another girl. I'm looking for another girl.
Ooit. Ooit zal zij de wereld beter maken. You don't have to do anything. It's my time to speak. And today is the day we will change the world. Are you getting all this? I think I am getting better at your language. Do you agree? Yes? It makes me a little sad to speak it, I have to say. But if you do not learn my language, eventually I will speak yours. Are you ready? Can we unlock the doors now, please? Ik heb een paar eisen. I have some demands.